All right, so today I'm gonna be fishing this godforsaken lake called Erieville. Second time I've ever fished it. Also, I'm looking for some fish for the New York State Winter Classic, some big fish, try and win. Just gonna put my you-know-what, you-know-where. Let's have some fun. That was quick, man. He just jumped on it right off the bottom. He came in really fast and hot. First fish of the day. Come on up, dingus. Oh yeah. I don't think so. It's a good fish, whatever it is. It's a pickerel. Huh, how about that? I haven't caught one of these guys in a hot minute. Hold on, let me get him here. There he is, nice little pickerel, cool. He's making noise. That's fun. There we go, 25 feet of water. I got the smallest fish in the world. Yep, there's a school of these guys down there. We're gonna have to keep moving. That is the tiniest perch I've ever caught in my life. There he is, there he is. That's a better fish. Finally, away from those dinks, walked a good 100 yards. Finally, good 22 feet of water right here. Please be a big perch. Nice, that's an eater perch. Very nice. Now we're talking, son. That's a little beauty. He hit right away, too. There he is. This wind is insanely brutal. I'm sure you can hear it. At 25 feet, just hopped another pole. What do we got here? Good sized perch, hopefully? Hopefully? Yes, beautiful. Cookie cutter eater, son. 10 inchers. Dude, open your mouth. Whatever. Look at the fatness of that guy. Beautiful perch. Very good. He's coming for it. Gonna meet him halfway. Nope. Oh, there he is. He's coming for it. There he is. Boom. Back to back, son. Yes, we're getting into a school of perch. I'm so happy. This is amazing. Yes. This is a little smaller guy, I think. Yeah? Cool. Definitely bigger than that first one, though. That's a plus. Cool. Little beauty. Oh, coming up for it again. There he is. This is a tiny guy. Really tiny guy. Must be mixed sizes in this school. Added another squeaker. He's going back in. Yeah, that might be another pickerel, man. He's a heavy fish. Might be a perch. Actually, it's not that. Oh, never mind. There he goes. Whee! Right on the edge of a weed bed here, man. We've been drilling Swiss cheese all over the place. Please don't fall off. Please don't fall off. You saw it? Okay. Pickerel.
Oh, it's a largemouth. It's a nice largemouth.
Is it?
Yeah.
Hold on, hold on, hold on. I got him. I got him, Corey. I got him.
Oh, smallmouth.
It's a smallmouth bass. Look at that. Get them lipped here. Nice little 15-16 inch smallmouth bass. Weird. Very strange.
Like a
yeah, I'm gonna throw him back, obviously. He's not in season. I'm gonna keep him anyway. Cool. Whoa. This guy's big. I don't know what it is, but it's big.
You want a deuce route?
Yeah, deuce route, please. Carefully. I don't know what this is, but man, he's a big chungus. Yeah, he's heavy.
Probably a pickerel or a bass.
Let's see here. He's coming up now. Oh, no, he's not. Please be a huge panfish. 25 feet of water, man. Takes forever to bring him up. Oh, it's a nice perch. Now we're talking. Look at that big chungus. 12, 13 incher with the biggest belly in the world. Now we're talking, girls. And there was multiple down there, too. I'm gonna drop my little dingus right back down there. Oh yeah, oh yeah. We got another big chungus on, I think. The good thing about those perch is they seem to bite down on the jig. So it's like, they don't fall off as easy as the crappies, it seems like. This is another good one.
Not the deucer out?
Yeah, deucer out.
Deucer
out. There we go. Not quite as big, I don't think. No, that's a nice one. Dude, we're on them. yes, we've been trying so hard all day to find the perch, and now we seem to be on a few. Very, very cool. Oh, dude, they're coming in hot. Holy cow. There's a bunch of them, too. Holy cow, look at all the freaking perch on the flasher. There's like 10 of them. Oh, dude, this one's even bigger. This one's even bigger. Yeah, I got it. I got the deucer. Holy cow. Dude, this is a miracle. Yeah, dude, there's a ton down there. Holy cow. Look at that. Dude, me and Corey are nailing them all of a sudden. This is a miracle. It's a Christmas miracle. Tiny one. Shoot. Where's the big ones again? Nuts. This guy's going back in. He's a little squeaker. It's weird how they're mixed together, small and big. Usually that doesn't happen. This has got to be another dink. Shoot. Dang it. Where'd those big ones go, man? There was a ton of them for just a moment. Shoot. I think this is another tiny one. Man, that breaks my heart. Where did the big ones go? Shoot. Nuts. I totally jinxed myself. Just lost 3 in a row. So frustrating. Darn transducer. Everything's breaking today. Very, very frustrating. There we go. That'll keep.
Compare whose is bigger.
Whose is bigger, Corey? Yours or mine?
I think yours might be a little bit bigger.
This is a good solid keeper. Oh, wow. Yep. Yep. There we go. Tiniest one in the world. Hip, hip, hooray. Oh, this is a big girl. Got her on the Swedish pimple. Oh, this is getting hard to just... tough fishing, man. They're just lookers, so many different lookers. So today I'm using my tuned-up custom rod, the bullwhip, with a Crappie Maxx reel and a lot of frustration, and 3-pound trilene micro ice. Man, 25 feet of water, man. You really gotta hork them up. Should be a good perch, I think. Yeah, yep, nice perch. Heck yeah. That little fatty. Nice. Beautiful. Woo-wee! Stupid little tiny ones. So annoying. Day 2. Let's see what happens. Look at that. There's a little spider out here on the ice about 70 yards in. Just chilling. I already lost 5 fish in a row. So disappointing. But this is the first fish of the day, hopefully. Hopefully. What we got here? Beautiful pumpkin seed. Look at that. That's a slabber. Definitely well over 8 inches. Not huge. I've caught 10 inches before, but that is a beauty. I just lost a small one and a big one right at the hole. Big pumpkin seed. Holy cow. This has got to be a bass. Either that or it's a 20-inch crappie. Holy cow, man. He's ripping. Holy cow. Please stay on the hook. I already lost 7 fish, which I don't understand at all. It's a big crappie. Yes. Big ol' crappie. Big ol' 12-inch crappie. Maybe even a little more. That is a 3 or 4 hander there, son. What a beautiful slab. Cool. There we go. There we go. The curse is over. They've stopped falling off, it seems like. Whoa. Beautiful crappie, yes. Look at that. They have to be 9 inches in New York to keep. This is a solid 10. Very beautiful purple iridescent crappie. Heck yeah, girls. They're just biting so light. 8 so far have fallen off the hook. Weird day. I might change out for a little ditch pickle. Might change out for a sharper hook, I'm thinking. Because they just keep falling off over and over, and it's so frustrating. Little ditch pickle going back in the drink. Oh my gosh, over and over they just keep biting the spikes off. This is what it is. Little squeaker nipper bluegill. They just keep being so annoying. I'm going to throw this guy back. Of course, he's too small. Nibble out to me. popping holes now. This is another heavy fish. Very cool. Get sick of those little 7-inch bluegills. Yes! It's a beautiful crappie. Look at that. A little smaller, but most likely still a keeper. They gotta be 9 inches. Yeah, girl. That last one just a little over 9. I dropped right back down and immediately got another hit. Crappies, son. We're getting crappies. This is a miracle. Yes, beautiful. That's a big one. There we go. Oh, shoot. Shoot. Almost lost them. That's a 12-incher right there. That's a beauty. They're so tall on the back, too. I have big hands, you know. They just got the girth. Oh, yeah. There's a bunch of them right there. There he is. Cool. There's a whole school of them down there. This guy's not as heavy, I don't think, but he's got a little bit of weight to him. Yes, beautiful. Perfect eater, pumpkin seed man, about 8 inches. Not too big, not too small. Perfect eater. He's got shoulders on him. So what I usually like to do to catch these fish is to jig it a bunch to get their attention. This is a good fish. And then after I jig it a bunch to get their attention, I dead stick it right in their face. And very large majority of the time they bite it. Yes, big old crappie. Oh, dude, these are slabs. Slabs, I say, man. Cookie cutter 12 inches, son. With big, tall backs on them. You gotta love it. You gotta love it. Trying to get some of these exciting bites on camera. Yeah, girl. Oh, dude, this is a hot hole. These crappies are just nice, man. They're really nice. They're not enormous, but they are really nice, high-quality crappies. There's another one. Yes! Something beautiful, 9.5. Yeah, probably about 9.5, 9.75. That'll work. That's a keeper. There he is. There he is. Very nice. It's sitting on my butt now, so a little bit more challenging to get the fish in. I think I might have been ripping it out of their mouths all morning. They might have been crappies and I was just ripping it out of their mouths because I was setting the hook so hard. Might just be. Beautiful pumpkin seed. Look at that. That is a slab. Dude, beautiful 9-inch pumpkin seed. How about that? Very round. Good shoulders on them. Thick as heck. Wow, what a beauty. So like I usually do, today I'm using a red and black tungsten teardrop, a little one, tipped with some spikes. Nice crappie, nice crappie. There we go. There we go. That might be a keeper. They gotta be 9. Nice little guy. Beautiful. Keep them coming. There he comes. There he is. Boom. So I'm hopping holes now. Quite a bit. Trying to find some fresh bites. Oh yeah, nice crappie. Nice crappie. Heck yeah. All these crappies so far have been legal. The two smallest ones were just a little bit over 9. This looks like another legal one, I'm guessing. There it is. The deadly doodle. My favorite little ice jig. Hopping holes quite a bit. There was a school down there for a hot minute. Been a while since I hooked a fish. Slowing down. I'm trying to make new holes and stuff. Get up here, dang it. Oh yeah, nice crappie. Very nice. Oh dude, I'll take these all day, man. Slabbers. 12 inch or sun tall in the back, healthy. Beautiful fish. Finally on another one. Yeah, girl, finally. Woo-wee! What we got? A little ditch pickle. Woohoo! This is the greatest day of my life. I'm having so much fun. I'm pretty sure I'm the only person on the lake that's catching fish. Yes, yes, what is it? Oh, big old pumpkin seed. Look at that beauty. Oh, that's just a gorgeous jumbo pumpkin seed right there. Cool. Too cool. He hit it 3 times. So what's so special about this bullwhip is that sensitive indicator spring is built into the rod, as you can see. Holy cow! Oh, dude, almost lost him. Wow, look at that pea seed. That is a gorgeous 9-inch pea seed right there. Beautiful pumpkin seed. That is bigger than my hand, and I have big hands. Oh, that's funny. What a specimen. Oh, yeah. There's a little school of them down there. If you can make them fight each other, usually that'll spur them on to bite, even if they have lockjaw, which they do sometimes pretty badly. Oh, yeah, this is a big fish. This is a big fish. He's taking drag. What are you? Nice crappie. Nice. Look at that slab. Oop. Look at that slab, man. 11 and a half, 12 inches. Beautiful. I am making Swiss cheese out of this place, but I'm also having a lot of fun. A little squeaker bluegill. I'll probably throw him back, I guess. He's right on the line of being filletable, I'd say. Yeah, he's a throwback. Oh, man. Ooh, there's a good fish. This hole has been pretty good to me. Lost a couple more, though, but that's okay. Whatever. That's the trouble of the day, then that's what it is. Nice. Look at that slab. Oh, my gosh. Look at that pumpkin seed. That is a beauty. I've caught bigger, significantly bigger, but this is still a really nice slab, 9-incher, with a huge breast on him, just girthy, thick. What a beauty. Oh yeah, this is a pretty good hole, ladies. We are racking and stacking them. Ooh, this is a good fish, he's pulling hard. Good fish, got a big old crappie. No, it's a big old pumpkin seed, maybe even a pumpkin gill. It doesn't have much red on the operculum. That is a beauty, man. These are 9+ inches. This might be over 9, but they're really round too. Got big shoulders on them, big bellies. I have a feeling this is a pumpkin gill because that reminds me of a bluegill, that breast. Maybe, just maybe. Back to back, I dropped it down and a new one immediately hit it. I love using 3-pound test, man. It's so nice. You can really hork a big bass up, like a 6 to 8 pounder on 3-pound test, pretty easily. That's why I don't go down to 2 or 1. There's a whole school of whatever this is down there, and they were fighting for it. So they decided to hit it, even though they were being cautious. Another nice crappie. Heck yeah, son. That looks like it might barely be a keeper. Little beauty. Whoa, 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 what are you doing? Nice. Heavy fish. Hit immediately after I threw that last crappie in the bucket. Dropped right down, and bam. Bam, I say. Oh, dude, another nice pumpkin seed. Oh, look at that beauty. Whoa, 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 take it easy. That is a perfect eater, man. Eight inches, maybe? Maybe a little more? Perfect. My hands are so cold and wet. Ooh, big fish. Every time I come out here, I destroy my hands and my knees. Big, bigger fish, nice. Everything feels big on this bullwhip, though, honestly. Oh, dude, I was hoping I wouldn't see this. It's my arch nemesis, the golden shiner. This place has so many of these stupid things. Throw them back. I think this is a crappie. It came off the bottom out of that big school of fish that's been moseying around in circles. I think it's a school of crappies, and I think I'm on them. Pretty sure. Nope, it's a little ditch pickle. Weird. There was a school of fish down there, so I wonder if it was bass, which is kind of strange, I think. But, yeah, whatever. Throw them back. Whatever this guy is, he came out of a school of fish. A big old school of fish. fighting really good too. I'm guessing it's a crappie. Guessing? No, it's another bass. There's a school of bass down there. How weird is that? There's a big old school of bass down there. They're all the same size too. They're all tiny. I've pricked so many of them at this point. And once they're pricked, they seem to just kind of hide for the rest of the day, which is unfortunate. Well, there we go. There's an eater gill. Beautiful. Not a big one, but a good quality eater, I'd say. Very purpley iridescent, just beautiful. Very nice. Well, almost everyone has left at this point. I'm thinking of packing it up soon anyway, too. A little squeaker, might be the last fish of the day. Too small, I'm gonna let him go. Squeaker. There we go, got another nice one. This one is most likely gonna be the last one of the day. About to leave, I think. Here we go, he's coming up fast, coming up hot. It's a beautiful pumpkin seed. Look at that slabber. Oh my gosh, these things are so thick. Look at that breast on it. So, so thick. What a beauty. There we go. Smoked them pretty good. Gonna be a good fish fry.